and I represent Imeko-Afo and Egbado North Federal Constituency. Mr. Speaker, I'm from Ogun State. Before I shed light on what I intend to amend on the EFCC Act, please permit me, Mr. Speaker, to also respond just very briefly to the last speaker. I want to commend the efforts, as well as the previous efforts by Honorable Osai, at ensuring that we give very special importance, as well as accord special recognition to this very important commission. But there are some things that we have to be very mindful of, so that we don't also overdo things. For instance, Mr. Speaker, in one of the bills, we are talking about the introduction of the special court to be presided over within, to be situated within the EFCC. You will recall, Mr. Speaker, that a special crimes court bill was read for the first time on the floor of the House 2 weeks ago. And what that intends to do, without any attempt to argue that bill, which is coming up tomorrow for debate, is to bring all the special crimes together, including the corruption issues, as well as terrorism and cybercrime. Put them together and assign them to a special court. So if we want to establish another court within this bill, by this amendment we seek to do, it will duplicate that effort. So I want the members to note that. Another thing that I would like to state here is on the issue of the proposed amendment on how much Section 35, internally, that 0.3% of the IGR shall be credited to the funds of the Commission. Whereas I also know, as a fact, Mr. Speaker, you know that in other crimes, efforts are made to give, to empower the commissions by giving them certain form of incentives from monies collected by them. I think it should be too much if we are asking them to charge from the money, from the recovered monies, 0.1%, as well as 0.3% of internally generated revenue of the federal government. We also have to be very careful in the sense that we also have to appropriate money to them. So it's not as if after this, all these ones, we are still not going to, we are not going to give them any money in the appropriation bill. So we are still going to give money to them. Therefore, we have to ensure that we don't just over-pamper the commission. Mr. Speaker, having said that, let me go straight to what I intend to achieve with my own amendment. Since last year, we've been attending meetings of the financial FATF, Financial Action Task Force, in France. And one of those, of the members of the delegation of Nigeria that have been attending the plenary of the FATF, and one of the recommendations of the FATF is that we have to amend our Section 1, Subsection 1B, 1C of the Commission's Act, which says that the EFCC shall be the designated financial intelligence unit of the country. According to the FATF, this does not give and will not give the financial intelligence unit the much-needed independence to operate. They have their recommendation, which they call Recommendation 29, which states that every financial intelligence unit shall be given its own autonomy, even though it can be situated within a bigger unit. In Nigeria, it is situated within the EFCC, whereas in some other places like the US, it is within the Treasury Department. In the UK, it is situated within the Organized Crimes Act Agency. In Germany, under the police, and in other countries like that. So what they are saying that it can be situated anywhere, but it has to be given its autonomy. You recall, Mr. Speaker, that at the last assembly, efforts were made by the assembly to take or to give the NFIU its autonomy through the establishment of the NFIC, the Nigeria Intelligence Financial Center. But of course, that did not go through because it was argued then, and I still believe rightly, that doing though would also give the NFIC, the Nigeria Intelligence Financial Intelligence Center, political pressure. So it is very necessary to incubate it within a bigger agency as we currently have it. But because we are having it there, the Egmont Group of Financial Intelligence Units are also recommending that we give autonomy, operational autonomy, to the NFIU. So what I intend to seek, I intend to achieve by this amendment is to amend Section 1, Subsection 1C of the EFCC Act to ensure that we give that autonomy, operational autonomy, to the Nigerian Financial Intelligence Unit. As a matter of fact, Mr. Speaker, where we are, considering the current budget, we've asked the EFCC to present a separate budget for the Nigerian Financial Intelligence Unit, which they have done. So in order to legalize what we are doing, we intend to amend this area. Another area, Mr. Speaker, that my amendment, my bill seeks to amend, is Section 20 of the EFCC Act. Section 20 of the EFCC Act is very close to what Honorable Pajok did last week when he brought a motion, a bill, to amend the same section of, in the EICPC Act. And what that is saying is that if a person is convicted under the Act, that the person will forfeit his assets to the federal government. But the question is, the federal government is not the only victim of financial, economic and financial crimes. And if we intend to achieve justice, any money recovered should not just go to the federal government, but it should go to the agency involved. It can be state government, it can be individuals, and it can be corporate entity. So why should we then say that under Section 20, when that a person is convicted, the person should forfeit the property to the federal government? So we seek to amend this to ensure that there is justice. Mr. Speaker, we also have the issue of the appointment of the EFCC chairman. Of course, currently, he's talking about a serving officer or a retired officer in any of the security agencies. We intend to expand the scope so that more candidates can be given the opportunity, as long as they are competent, particularly if they are lawyers, with at least 15 years post-call, as it has been done in the ICPC Act. Again, to support what my previous speaker said, in terms of giving the autonomy to the EFCC, we know right now that the EFCC is not under the first line charge, unlike we have with the ICPC. If you want to check the EFCC budget, you have to go to the presidency. So it's made to be an appendage of the presidency. And we have to take it away so that it can have the necessary autonomy and independence to perform its operations. Mr. Speaker, honorable colleagues, that is what my own bill intends to achieve. And I know that by the time we put everything together and we get to the committee stage, every area that I've mentioned, and some other areas, of course, that we feel that we can do to ensure that we give necessary empowerment to this commission to ensure to be able to perform its functions and duties more effectively well, we'll do it. Mr. Speaker, distinguished colleagues, I wish to appeal to you to support this amendment and to vote in its favor. Thank you very much.